Hi everyone, and welcome back to CzechClass101.com. This is Intermediate Season 1, Lesson 14. Newsflash in the Czech Republic. Michael here.
Ahoj, I'm Veronika.
In this lesson, you'll learn about the singular and plural locative case. The conversation takes place at a TV news station.
It's between a TV reporter and Vojtěch Vidra.
The speakers are strangers, therefore they will speak formal Czech. Okay, let's listen to the conversation.
Další dopravní nehoda se stala v pražských Dejvicích. Jak to na místě vypadá, popíše dopravní strážník pan Vidra.
V zastávce Dejvická narazil osobní automobil do tramvaje. Místo nehody zajišťují záchranáři i hasiči.
Jsou na místě nehody zraněné osoby?
Ano, v osobním automobilu se zranil spolujezdec. V nemocnici také skončili 3 cestující tramvaje.
Dnes je to již druhá nehoda automobilu a tramvaje. První se stala ráno v pražských Strašnicích.
Ano, je to tak. Ranní nehodu ve Strašnicích způsobil řidič tramvaje, který přehlédl signalizaci.
Došlo i tam ke zranění?
Nikoli, ranní nehoda se obešla bez zranění. Vznikly pouze škody na vozidlech.
V jakých hodinách můžeme očekávat obnovení provozu?
V 18 hodin by měl být v Dejvicích provoz plně obnoven.
Listen to the conversation with the English translation.
Další dopravní nehoda se stala v pražských Dejvicích. Jak to na místě vypadá, popíše dopravní strážník pan Vidra.
Another traffic accident happened on Prague's Dejvice. The traffic policeman, Mr. Vidra, will describe how it looks on the site.
V zastávce Dejvická narazil osobní automobil do tramvaje. Místo nehody zajišťují záchranáři i hasiči.
At the stop Dejvická, a car crashed into a tram. The site of the accident was attended by paramedics and firefighters.
Jsou na místě nehody zraněné osoby?
Are there any injured people at the site of the accident?
Ano, v osobním automobilu se zranil spolujezdec. V nemocnici také skončili 3 cestující tramvaje.
Yes, a passenger in the car was injured. 3 passengers from the tram ended up in the hospital.
Dnes je to již druhá nehoda automobilu a tramvaje. První se stala ráno v pražských Strašnicích.
Today it is already the second accident of a car and a tram. The first one happened in the morning, in Prague's Strašnice.
Ano, je to tak. Ranní nehodu ve Strašnicích způsobil řidič tramvaje, který přehlédl signalizaci.
Yes, that's right. The tram driver who missed the traffic lights caused the morning accident.
Došlo i tam ke zranění?
Were there injuries as well?
Nikoli. Ranní nehoda se obešla bez zranění. Vznikly pouze škody na vozidlech.
No. The morning accident was without any injuries. Only vehicles were damaged.
V jakých hodinách můžeme očekávat obnovení provozu?
In what hours can we expect the traffic to resume?
V 18 hodin by měl být v Dejvicích provoz plně obnoven.
At 6 p.m., the traffic in Dejvice should fully resume. I'm sure that most people listening to this know that Prague is the capital and largest city in the Czech Republic. What else can you tell us about it, Veronica?
It's located almost in the middle of Bohemia, on the Vltava River, in the central Bohemian region.
It's the administrative center of this region, but does function as an independent region.
Prague is a political, economic, cultural, university and science center.
It's always been the seat of the President of the Republic, the government, the High Court, and many other important offices and representations. So with all of these important places in Prague, I presume there are a lot of sites for tourists to see.
That's right. In the center you can count over 1,200 cultural and historical buildings. In total, there are almost 3,000 of these buildings in Prague.
There are so many rich cultural events in Prague. How is Prague divided?
This is complicated. There are several different methods of division that are used at the same time.
Can you believe that Prague is divided into 10 city districts, 22 administrative districts, 57 city parts, and 112 cadastral areas?
Historically, the most important parts of Prague are mainly located on the territory of today's Prague 1.
This is the territory of the medieval part of the city, inscribed on the UNESCO World Heritage List since 1992.
There are many tourist spots here, such as the Prague Castle, Old Town Square, and Charles Bridge.
Okay, now on to the vocab. Let's take a look at the vocabulary from this lesson. The first word is
dopravní.
Traffic.
Dopravní. Dopravní.
Next we have
nehoda.
Accident.
Nehoda. Nehoda.
Next we have
narazit.
To crash.
Narazit. Narazit.
Next we have
vozidlo.
Vehicle.
Vozidlo. Vozidlo.
Next we have
záchranář.
Paramedic, rescuer.
Záchranář. Záchranář.
Next we have
hasič.
Fireman.
Hasič. Hasič.
Next we have
zranit se.
To get hurt.
Zranit se. Zranit se.
Next we have
zranění.
Injury.
Zranění. Zranění.
Next we have
řidič.
Driver.
Řidič. Řidič.
And last
spolujezdec.
Passenger.
Spolujezdec. Spolujezdec.
Let's have a closer look at the usage of some of the words and phrases from this lesson. The first phrase is
stala se dopravní nehoda,
meaning a traffic accident happened. The first part of this phrase is a past participle.
Stala se, it comes from the reflexive verb stát se.
This means to become. The past participle changes its form depending on the noun it connects to. In this case, it connects to the feminine noun.
Nehoda.
Meaning accident. The phrase is used in news to announce the fact that a traffic accident occurred. Can you give us an example using this phrase?
Sure. For example, you can say na hlavní ulici se stala dopravní nehoda.
Which means there was a traffic accident on Main Street. Okay, what's the next phrase?
Vznikly škody na vozidlech.
Meaning vehicles were damaged. The literal meaning of this phrase, though, is damage of vehicles occurred.
The noun vozidlo, vehicle, is more general than auto,
which means car. Unlike in English, the noun damage, when talking about harm or injury, is countable.
In Czech, damage is škoda.
Can you give us an example using this phrase?
Sure. For example, you can say během dopravní nehody vznikly škody na vozidlech.
Which means damage to vehicles occurred during the accident. Okay, now on to the lesson focus. In this lesson, you'll learn about the singular and plural locative case. The locative case is the only Czech case that is never used without a preposition. This case is used to indicate the location of someone or something in space or in time. It follows after five prepositions, which are
ve,
in,
na,
on,
o,
about,
při,
during,
po,
after. The lesson notes has a full declension table for masculine, feminine, and neuter, so make sure to check that out. Let's hear some sentence examples, beginning with the singular locative case.
V České republice je čeština oficiální jazyk.
Czech is the official language of the Czech Republic.
Po obědě půjdeme na procházku.
After lunch, we will go for a walk.
V rádiu mluvili o autonehodě.
They spoke about a car accident on the radio. The forms of locative case in the plural form are different from those in the singular.
You will find a full declension table in the lesson notes.
When applying the locative case, the whole noun phrase requires changes, including demonstrative, possessive pronouns, and adjectives. As you'll see in the declension table in the lesson notes, the locative endings of masculine and neuter demonstrative possessive pronouns and adjectives in singular are identical.
However, the locative endings of feminine demonstrative, possessive pronouns, and adjectives differ.
And the locative endings of masculine, feminine, and neuter demonstrative, possessive pronouns, and adjectives in plural are identical. Now, let's hear some examples.
V osobním automobilu se zranil spolujezdec.
A passenger in the car was injured.
Nehoda se stala v pražských Strašnicích.
The accident happened on Prague's Strašnice.
Mluvila špatně o mých dobrých kamarádech.
She spoke badly about my good friends.
Ve velkých městech je mnoho dopravních nehod.
There are many traffic accidents in big cities.
Musíme si promluvit o vašich dcerách.
We need to talk about your daughters. Personal pronouns also change their form in the locative case, and the full list of these can be found in the lesson notes. Veronica, can we hear some example sentences?
Mluvili jsme o nás.
We talked about us.
Ten dárek je pro vás.
That gift is for you.
Co se ti na nich líbí?
What do you like about them? In Czech, there are many local names of cities, towns, and their parts which only have plural forms, even though they refer to a singular place. Such Czech local names are always combined with plural forms of verbs, adjectives, and pronouns.
These are called zeměpisná jména pomnožná.
In English, this is pluralia tantum, or plural local names. It's often difficult to classify the gender of these places, which causes uncertainty in the choice of their forms. Most of them are feminine or inanimate masculine words. Plural local names ending in pronunciation with
I
can be either masculine or feminine. For example,
Na Hradčanech se nachází Pražský hrad.
Prague Castle is located in Hradčany.
Hradčany follows the pattern Hrady. Another example is Na prázdniny pojedeme do severních Čech.
We will go to northern Bohemia for the holidays.
Čechy follows the pattern ženy.
Plural local names that end with
ice are feminine nouns following the růže pattern.
And plural local names that end with
e are mostly masculine following the pattern stroj. For example, další dopravní nehoda se stala v pražských Davicích.
Another traffic accident happened in Prague's Davice.
Metro jede do Hájů.
The metro goes to Hajé. Our last category of plural local names end with
a. These are neuter and follow the pattern město.
Let's finish with an example.
Jede tento autobus do Napajedel?
Is this bus going to Napajedla? Okay, that's all for this lesson. Thank you for listening, everyone, and we'll see you next time. Bye.
Naschledanou. Další dopravní nehoda se stala v pražských Dejvicích. Jak to na místě vypadá, popíše dopravní strážník pan Vidra.
V zastávce Davidská narazil osobní automobil do tramvaje. Místo nehody zajišťují záchranáři i hasiči.
Jsou na místě nehody zraněné osoby?
Ano, v osobním automobilu se zranil spolujezdec. V nemocnici také skončili 3 cestující tramvaje.
Dnes je to již druhá nehoda automobilu a tramvaje. První se stala ráno v pražských Strašnicích.
Ano, je to tak. Ranní nehodu ve Strašnicích způsobil řidič tramvaje, který přehlédl signalizaci.
Došlo i tam ke zranění?
Nikoli, ranní nehoda se obešla bez zranění. Vznikly pouze škody na vozidlech.
V jakých hodinách můžeme očekávat obnovení provozu?
V 18 hodin by měl být v Dejvicích provoz plně obnoven.